9:13 says, from heaven, the Lord looks down and sees all mankind. 1 Peter 3:12 says, for the eyes of the Lord are on the righteous, and his ears are open to their prayer. I am praying right now in the name of Jesus. So pray along with me. Father, I come live from Cleveland, Tennessee on Christian Television Network with your word, dear God. I'm asking that Lord to use me, dear Lord. Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart, Lord, let it be acceptable unto you. Oh God, my strength, my redeemer. I pray that God for our community, dear God. I pray that God, Jesus, especially that God, Jesus, for our 7 continents. I pray that God, where World Wide Web, Facebook is hearing this message, that they will be a blessing. I'm asking that Lord Jesus, my Father, to let me, that God Jesus, my Father, allow you to speak through me with what you give me to say. And I'm thanking you, that God, for using me once again. God bless you. And I want you to enjoy this message, because this is something God has given me to bring to you. I want you to know that God has a 2020 vision on his sight. Where I got this message from is because in the Bahamas, like you can see, I'm representing my country. I'm involved with Women United in Prayer. And their theme this month is El Rahi, whatever you say. But it means the God who sees. And they assigned me with a prayer. And as I was studying, the Lord said, no, you take this into a message. So I want to dedicate this half an hour message to the woman United in Prayer in Nassau, Bahamas. And I want you to know Genesis 16:13 says, listen, Hagar, you need to listen very carefully what I'm going to say, because I've already been blessed. And I want you to be blessed and hear what God is saying. Because Hagar says that she called on the name of the Lord. And she said God spoke to her. Okay? And I'm the God who sees. He's the God who sees, she said. For she said that she was in the wilderness, like you know the story with Abraham and Sarah couldn't have a child, and they had Hagar. The story how Sarah was the one who allowed Hagar to go along as a maiden to have this child. And what this caused is caused a lot of frustration. It caused depression. And modernized, we'll say that it caused her to went crazy, because she ran away. She ran into the wilderness. She hit. And what it did, it brought depression. It brought stress. And as she was in there, she cried to the Lord in the desert. And I want you to know, woman, God is speaking to us that win-win situation, similar to, and all of us may have went through something, or will go through, or going through now. Hagar's story in Genesis 3:16, you need to identify with her, because she cried to the Lord. Again, like I said, our theme for United Woman in Prayer is El Rahi. Okay, that's the God who sees. And God can see you. He knows everything about you. And like Sarah Hagar said, she said that in her wilderness, she remained alive. She said, who sees me? She said she felt God present. She felt God anointed. And she knew God saw her. So I'm here to let you know, woman of God, woman of faith, unsaved woman, whatever woman you are in the situation, whoever listening, God is not blind. God doesn't have cataract. Listen, God is, his eyes are not dim. Okay? I'm speaking today now. I want you to listen. To understand this, you have to have compassion upon this young lady. Because here she was, Hagar, and each and every one of you, listen. She said here that, she said, I want to show you how strong she was. She was committed, and she was able to feel the fact that she created El Rahu. Okay? She was the one who cried out, and she found this name. So I want you to know, you, when you cry out to the Lord, whatever sound you make, okay, Rafi, whatever sound you make, that's the God who sees you. You're crying out to God. Come on now, use the parallel. Use what, yes, Hagar did. going through circumstance, a situation that nobody could understand. Why are you going through it? You need to know that God sees you. Okay, men, Hagar and Sarah, when she got pregnant, that's the part about it. Many of us, God is saying, we are pregnant. You're pregnant with your pain. You're pregnant with your situation. You're pregnant because you're being abandoned. You are pregnant because of what situation you were in. And you have to realize you have to birth that child. You have to birth that baby. You have to bring that forth. That's your ministry. And what God is saying, and what I've heard him saying, that many under the sound of my voice, you need to open your mouth and cry out to El Rafi. The Lord, he sees you and he understands you and he knows everything about you. Okay? He is God. Hagar got, and she put out, when she was put out of the house, like I said, and as she was in this desert and going through her situation, she was going through a psychological, emotional, come on, mentally, because she felt all alone. She was all alone until she cried out, and she cried, and she cried, and she cried. El Rafi heard her. Okay, he heard her. R-O-I, Rafi. Okay, I want you to know God hear you. He understand you. And in that desert, she reached. God revealed himself to her. He revealed. You need God. We all need God. Come on now. Like I said, this program or this session is dedicated because 5 o'clock every morning, I get up, go online, praying with a prayer group. A woman crying out, even some men, crying out to the Lord. Praying, seeking the Lord for Abraham Alan, all from Freeport all the way down to Crooked Island, Acklands, all the way down to Meguana, Aminagua, all the islands, Exuma. I want you to know every theme of 80 women or more, every Friday, every morning, 7 days a week, praying. And I want them to know, God, hear our cry. He hear you. He hear you, woman. He hear you. Because God showed me the prayer and the meditation, or even the medication you're taking. I want you to know God spoke. And he said, bring this message to let you know that he hear you. He hear you and he's answering you. God revealed himself just how he did to Hagar. He said, Hagar's story is a lesson for us. Yes, Hagar was a slave. Come on now, she was a slave. She was the least of the least. And when she went into Abraham and Sarah's house, you all know the story. Read the story. Go in Genesis and read the story. And you may say your story and her story or the next one's story, whoever's story. Your story is to help others. Your story is to get you to your ministry. Your story is to cry out for your Bahama line. Your story, and even my other prayer group, I have other prayer group. I want you to know, wherever you listen, I have prayer group, but other prayer groups, and y'all know who you are. I want you to know, God is speaking to us to know that we have to look in the Bible, and when we find things and story like this, let me say, I'm focusing on Genesis 16 and 13. God who sees me and you, okay, he sees us all. Don't be afraid to express your anger and your distress, he's saying. Cry out, okay? Cry out in your desert. Cry out in whatever situation. You will hear God because El Rafi, he is listening and he can see. Like I said, God has 20/20 vision and he understands you. He can feel your pain. The path and the journey you are taking is to help you to know, listen, that just how you, how Hagar allow herself to cry out. God is saying that you need to allow yourself lay across and allow God to speak to you so you can see him. Because she remained in prayer. She saw God. She felt him. She understood him. And she knew God looked after her. And that's what God said. He's looking after you. He's looking at your situation. He's looking at every joining you were taking. He understands you. And I want the question I want to ask you. Okay? Have you ever been abandoned? Have you ever felt like you've been mistreated? Have you ever been abused? Okay? Have you ever been mistreated? Misunderstood? All of these things. all of these situations, God is saying that, you know, even you who being sexually abused, physically abused, your spouse may abuse you, you're being cast away, you're being down in the dungeon, you're being in the deepest if you can be, you're being, people talked about you, and they just threw you aside. I'm telling you, look at this story of Hagar and study. You will see what God is saying, that when you, he sees everything, whatever going through. Man, this for you too. Come on now, some of us men are being mistreated. I'm telling you, you have to see yourself, understand. The Bible, this Bible, God put story in this Bible. Some we don't understand. But listen here, it's for us to apply it and to see ourselves and how can we identify with the word of God and get ourselves to say, okay, God, this is where I am. This is what I'm going to do. Hagar, what she did, she recognized that she needed God. And when she began to cry out, she saw God, and God saw her, and God healed her, and he set her free. Because guess what? Guess what? Like I said, she had to go back. With her pain, yes, with her pain, she has to stay back. Because she heard God call, and God is speaking right now. God told her to go back to Sarah. And some of you, God's saying to go back. You know what? You have to identify with your enemy. You have to let your, I'm not afraid of this situation. Because I heard from God, and God sees me, and he is filling me with the Holy Ghost. He is giving me the power. He's sanctifying me. Oh, Bahamut, I'm telling you, this message came through you. You all know your theme is the God who sees. And I want you to know God is watching. God is watching. I'm going to give you some scripture. God is watching on everyone. He is God. Woman, I want you to know God is with us and he is all around us. A promised child. God who saw it. Psalms 34 and 15 says, listen, want you to know that, this is David, that just how he revealed himself to a fugitive slave. You know, and she was one who, like I said, was looked down on. But she allowed this experience to see and feel. And that's why I want you to really see the Genesis 16 and 13. Really focus on that. In spite of it, Job reminds us in Job 34 and 21. Job said, for his eyes, this El Rahi, okay, are on the ways of man. And he sees all our step, every move, everything we do. Facebook, I want you to know, I'm coming live to let you know as you flip through. God knows your path. You can hide, others can hide and hit you. No matter what, God knows the inner part of you, and he sees you. He said, that's the part he's saying. R-O-E-L-R-O-I. God is with you. And he sees you. Jeremiah, do we remind us in Jeremiah 1 and 5? He said, before I was formed in my mother's womb, he said, I knew you. You have to understand this. If you don't really comprehend nothing, I want you to know that there's a God, and he created you, and he knew before you was conceived in your mother's womb. He had a purpose and a plan, like Jeremiah 29:11 said. He has a plan for future for you to do good and not evil, to prosper you, and for you to succeed and be great in the name of Jesus. Remember, Hagar, God's voice. She heard God's voice. And I hope you are hearing God's voice right now, because God's voice spoke to me through my trials and my tribulation, what I've been through, where I've been with my Sarah situation and my Hagar. God spoke, and he can do it for you. I've been healed. I've been delivered from sickness, disease, pain. God healed me. And I'm telling you who are listening, God can do it for you. You just got to cry out. Cry out to him and say, Lord Jesus, I need you. I need you. Because every circumstance, every situation will be healed with this word of God. Hagar said to El Rahi, she said, I see you and you are looking out for me. He is looking out for you. That song said, I know God is looking out. He's looking out for me and he's after you. He recognized you. Okay? You have to recognize him. He's visible. Feel him. Touch him. The Holy Ghost, the power of God is with you. Okay? El Rahi, the God who sees, has full. Like I said, his eyes are full. They're big and he can see everything, the whole wide world, every seven continents. He's with you. He's with you. David reminds us in David in Psalms 15 and 3:8. This is what David said. The eyes of the Lord are everywhere. I told you, keeping watch. He's keeping watch on the wicked and the good. Oh, hallelujah. The wicked and the good. God knows what you're doing. If you're doing evil, you need to repent. God says, I've been studying. You need to repent, my brother, my sister, whoever listening. You need to repent, ask for forgiveness, because he says here, I have an invitation for you to come face to face, like Sarah did and Hagar. She went back, you know, and she lived up. She didn't do nothing wrong, but what she meant, she let them know, okay, I'm back, okay? You may be lost as a sinner, okay? Come back to Jesus, or you may need to come back and say, Lord, I repent. Whatever your situation, your circumstances, you may never even repeat the sinner's prayer. I want you to know, cry out to God just like Hagar. This story is for everyone to look in their hearts, look in our mind, so we can be healed. You need to be healed to know God sees you. You've been dealing with circumstances. You've been dealing with situation. You have this burden. You have this anger, whatever God is speaking right now. You have something that you're not fully surrendering. That's what he wants you. He wants you to surrender to him right now. Surrender. Surrender. I see your God is saying you're lost. You may be lost. You may need to cry out, like I said to Al Rafi. God who sees us, that you to look. That's the eyes, to look upon him. Roll me. Look upon him. Look upon him. Because he's looking upon you. His eyes are down on everyone. And you need to repent now and say, Jesus, I accept your word. I accept this word. This is your word. I accept and I believe your word. And I believe this word can save me. I believe that, God, Jesus, you can heal me from my disease, my sickness, my pain, my sin. So I repent. And that's what I want you to do. Repent and ask God that come into your heart. Ask him to set you free so you can be delivered. And so you can have a freedom. You can have God keeping his eyes. Psalms, and even in Psalms 15 and B, you know, keeping his eyes on everyone. The eyes of the God, every island in the Bahamas, the 700 islands, the rocks, the keys, the banks. I want you to know as we pray every morning, 5 o'clock, God hears our cry. As we cry out, as we ask God to heal the prime minister, the general, the governor general, and all the islands, and the political party, and the religious leader, in the name of Jesus, as we celebrate our 50 jubilee, 50 years, my God, as independent, we thank God, hallelujah, we give him the praise, because he hears our cry, and he sees us up there, he sees our island, he sees every key, he sees everybody what we are doing. And he wants us to be faithful, be committed. Oh, help me, Lord Jesus, my God. David also said again in Psalms 33 and 18, the eyes of the Lord, like I said, are on those who fear him. Fear God, okay? Do you love him, okay? You need to understand the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. You have to understand this is godly fear now. God is saying, as I said, my focus is on Genesis 16 and 13, for you to really see that God is a God who can see. Don't ever forget that. God is looking down, and he can see every corner of the earth, every part of this 7 continents world, this globe as it's been. God can see what we're doing, the good and the evil. As I said, welcome to the kingdom of God. You just repented of your sins, and you ask Jesus to come into your heart. You ask him to, you repented, and you redeem. So welcome. And you need to read your Bible and follow up and get someone to help you. Because as you read, God will reveal to you who you need to. Churches, get yourself organized this year. This is 2023. He said you need to be disciplined with your word and with your Bible study. Get involved in prayer group. I hear it, God. Holly said, get involved in a prayer group. Get involved with Bible study so you can get help. Okay? God is speaking. He is speaking. My God, Rafi. Ask God to come into your heart. And he's came into your heart. Ask him, remember. Listen here, you need to remember. There is no creature hidden from the sight of God. Listen, Hebrews. Go in Hebrews 4 and 13. Okay? No creature, nobody is hidden from the sight of God. All things are naked and open to the eyes of God. Okay? To whom we must give account. Like I just said, you must give account. So make sure you're being accountable. When you come to Jesus, you give him your heart, and you say, I repent, and you ask Jesus to come into your heart. Bahamallah, like I told you the last day, you repented. Now you need to be accountable to a pastor. Be accountable to some Christians. Be accountable to a prayer group, a small group. Get accountability. That's what's going to make our island strong. I heard on Spencer's program, Mr. Finlayson doing a great job. Thank God for these people, the Christian people trying to get prayer. doing God's work. Get involved with the family. Family, bringing families back together. That's the foundation of the country. The foundation is Christian family. Oh, help me, because I got how many more minutes? Let me listen here. I just want you to know, focus on, like I said, on the God who see. The God who see. He can see. Just remember that. He can see you. He can see our sea, S-E-A. He can see our shore. He can see every creature, every Bahamian, every American, every the 50 states. The world, the seven continents, he see every bit, so don't feel like it. Don't feel, because the scripture tells us he looked down on the just, on the unjust. He is seeing everything. His eyes is open to everybody whom we must be accountable, like I said. And it says here, listen, it says here, even, Paul, no, this is Ezra reminds us in 2 Chronicles 16 and 9. He said that the eyes of the Lord, listen, it searched the whole earth. I just told you that. In order to strengthen those who are fully committed. That's what we're talking about. You got to be committed to God and His Word. You got to be committed. Don't let nobody, nothing stop you. You got to be committed. You have to be consecrated. And you have to be, what other word to say? Concentrating. Oh, Jesus, my God, I'm telling you. God is saying that you have to. You have to understand, be disciplined, like I said, and be a disciple, and be, what's the other word I'm looking for? I just want you to know, you got to be organized, like God said, you got to organize yourself so you can get up in the morning, you have 5 o'clock prayer meeting, or 7 or 6 o'clock, and you start your day, and you move, and God will lead you and guide you on the path you should go. That's what he's saying. God is helping us. And this is what Esther said in wherever this out of mind. Okay, 2 Chronicles 16 and 9, 8. That the eyes of the Lord search the whole earth in order to strengthen those who are fully committed to him. You have given him your heart. You've just given that. So praise the Lord. Thank him. Say, praise the Lord. Welcome to the kingdom of God. Like I said, thank you. Come on now. Wherever this heart of we love you. But God loves you the best. But he wants you to know that you got to stay committed. You got to stay committed, and you have to make yourself accountable. Accountable to someone. Make somebody make you accountable. Come on now. We don't have to get going. We're soon getting ready to start Christmas practice and Christmas program. And the year of them will be in 2024 and 25. And God, he's coming soon. You better be ready. So stay committed so you'll be ready when Christ calls you. Before you come back, he may call some of us. All of us ain't going to be in the rapture. So get yourself ready for the coming of the Lord. So the Lord, listen, and the Lord watch over your coming out and your going back and forth, both now and forever. He watching you. He watching all of us. Like I said, he is watching everything we do, everything we say, and he knows our heart. He knows our desire, and he wants us, like they said, in Psalms 51. Go to Psalms 51, because that's another thing we've been concentrating a lot on our prayer. A woman united in prayer. Again, I'm so happy to be a part of this group, and I thank my friend, Sister Clark, from San Ynez. She invited me, and I think they're going to get me inducted in and be more, because I have to pray Monday, and I feel good because, you know what, although I have some prayer groups here in the United States on Monday, and at my church, Joni Dale, I thank God for these prayer groups at South Cleveland Church, or at my local church on Sunday morning with all the pastors, but I thank God I accept this invitation because it's like I have to be accountable. I have to be accountable for the Bahamas. That's my territory. That's my birthplace. That's my home, my people, my family in the name of Jesus. And the Lord says he wanted to invite me for another group because sometimes we don't want to get all alone, all booked. I call it, but I thank God I accept this one because I felt like this was God. Because 5 o'clock is the time I usually up, but every morning I have to be up because I'm praying for my nation. I'm praying for my people. I want you to know we are praying, we are fasting, we are seeking God because we want a better country, we want a better nation, we want better people, we want godly people, we want holy, righteous people because God is calling us to do what he called. Get Psalm 51. That's another one we've been concentrating on. We've been concentrating on that, so I want you to get it because this is the repent. I think we've been reading this just for every morning. My God, get your Bible. I want you to read this with me in the last few minutes because, like I said, God has spoken. He has spoken, and my main thing is always when God speak through me, for me to bring forth, to burn it up, to let you know. That's why I'm live Facebook. You know, usually I do this. I'm a Christian television network. Right now, for the program for Sunday, and then on Saturday, I do the radio. God bless me with this ministry, and I thank God I'm being accountable to God, and I'm being committed and obedient. That's what God is saying. You got to be obedient. You have to find time and all the nice stuff. He said, some of you, he's calling you, and some of you ain't moved yet. You better move. God is speaking, and he wants you to birth this cry out to him. He got you covered. He sees you. He knows, and he will help you organize your time. He will help you manage your time. He will help you organize your schedule. He will help you. You got to ask him. You got to ask him as you cry out like Hagar. He will show you. He will show you, and he'll help you with your circumstance, help you with all that happened to you. Because you know what? It's a transformation. We all went through that. I went through a couple. Transformation makes a difference in your life. Because once you've been transformed, you've seen the eyes of God, you've seen Jesus. Nobody and nothing. Because that was your experience. That was your experience. Okay, Psalms 51. We're going to close on this. And the Lord bless you. Psalms 51. I want you to read this along with me, because we've been reading. I believe we all need to repent of something every now and then, just to make sure we need to keep reading, keep reading, keep reading. Because, you know, sometimes you could just offend somebody. Some people get offended real easy, you know. And we in sin, but we can say, have mercy upon me, O God, according to your steadfast love, according to your abundant mercy. Blot out my transgression, Lord. Wash me thoroughly from my iniquity and cleanse me, Lord, from my sin. Listen, for I know my transgression and my sin is ever before me. Listen, against me, you only have I sinned and done what is evil in your sight, Lord. Oh God, help me so that you may be justified in your words and blameless in your judgment. Verse 5 says, behold, I was brought forth in iniquity, and in sin did my mother conceive me. Listen, behold, you delight in truth and inward being, and you teach me wisdom in the secret heart. Purge me with hyssop, Lord, and I shall be clean. Wash me, and I shall be whiter than snow. Lord Jesus, let me hear the joy and gladness. Let the bones that you have broken rejoice. Hide your face from my sin, and blot out all the iniquities. Lord, look here, Lord, created me, O God, a clean heart, and renew the spirit within me. Cast me not away from your presence, O God, just speak at it. Lord, cast me not away from your presence. Let your presence stick with me, Lord, and take not your Holy Spirit from me. O God, Jesus, restore in me, God, the joy of your salvation, and uphold me with the willingness spirit, Lord Jesus. Then I will teach transgression your ways, and sinners will return to you. Oh, Lord, deliver me from blood guiltiness, Lord. Oh, God of my salvation, and my tongue shall sing for aloud your righteousness. Oh, Lord, open now my lips, and my mouth will declare your praises. Oh, God, for you will delight that God in sacrifice, and I will give it, and you will not be pleased with burnt offering. But the sacrifice of God are a broken spirit, a broken and a contrite heart. Oh, God, you will not despise. Do good to Zion in your good pleasure. Build up the walls of Jerusalem, my God. Then will you delight in righteousness, in burnt offering, and in whole burnt offerings. Then bulls will be offered in your altar. Amen. God bless you, and may the Lord keep you, and his face shine upon you. May God be gracious unto everyone, and holiness. Oh, God, thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Lord, just lift your hands. Just lift your hands. Tell my engineer come to cut this off. Just lift your hands. Just lift your hands. God is going to bless you. He is going to keep you. And he is going to do great things in your life. Facebook, thank you for joining. Please share the story of Hagar. Please, because everyone, like I said, can identify somewhere along the line that they need to see Jesus in this story in Genesis. They need to know God is with them. I love you, but you know God loves you the best. In Jesus' name I pray. Again, amen. And have a beautiful week. Have a beautiful week. Amen.